Welcome to the Tomarosa. Spring is in the air, and before we know it, it's going to be haying season. I've pulled the snow plow off the Cub, and now it's time to get ready to put on our Cub 22 sickle bar mower. I have a couple knives for my Cub 22 mower, and the reason being is I have one which I call my hay knife, which is this knife, which because of our wheel on our outer shoe always rides high, so I don't have to worry about hitting rocks or anything like that. So I want to keep this one really sharp and super well maintained. Well, this is what I call my weed knife. It runs lower. I might hit a little rock now and then. It still cuts, but it doesn't do as fine a job. We hayed last season with our Cub, and it did really well. A couple times we'd have clogging issues, both at the inner and outer shoe. So one thing I'm going to do for this season is on the outer end of the knife, I'm going to replace this last blade with a double end section. And I found these at my local farm store. And this is the first time I've ever tried these, but I'm going to try it and see if it improves the cutting on the outer shoe. This is my sickle tool that I bought from a neighbor for 10 bucks, and it's really pretty handy. It's got two functions. On this side, you can use this pin to punch rivets out, and then on this side, you can peen rivets in. Before I start working on my knives, I want to make sure I put on good leather gloves because these are sharp, and I definitely don't want to cut myself. To remove this last sickle section, what I do is I have it sitting in a loose vise here. So the knife bar itself, which is in the back, is resting on the edge of the vise. And with a couple well-placed hammer blows, I should be able to shear the rivets and remove that knife. So since I'm adding this new knife that extends out past the end of the bar just a little bit, I was looking at where International had originally cut it, and I noticed that it was kind of peened out a little bit. So just to make sure that everything lays nice and flat, I'm going to take a file real quick and just make sure that that's smoothed out. So I got it all set up. I'm ready to peen the rivet. I have rivets in both holes just so I know they'll always line up even after I tighten this. And I also have a little C-clamp here, which will make sure that my sickle section's held tight to the bar. So I have a fast hitch on my tractor, and because of that, you have to hold it up out of the way so it doesn't rub on anything when you're using the mower. So it has this bracket here that's designed to basically hold everything up. So you can lift it up and it goes over this bar. So I'm going to go ahead and hang my belt on my rear pulley here. And it's important to know that these pulleys are extremely expensive, so make sure that if you have one that your bolt is tightened down and that through the hole you have a snug fitting roll pin so there's no play on this. This is what happened to my last one, was there was a little bit of play and it wore out the spline, so I had to buy a new one. It's very expensive. So now I'm going to try and maneuver the power shaft towards the back of the tractor and up underneath. On the front here, I'm going to go ahead and hang it. I already have my bolt started. It's important to know that these are cone-shaped bolts. They have a taper to them, and that fits into the camphor around the bracket. But I have bolts on both sides, just kind of loose. I'm just going to hang this up. That went much better. So I have this hung, but I'm just going to leave these bolts loose for now until I get the back end secured. To mount the rear bracket, I actually have to remove two of the bolts that are holding the fast hitch on. So I'll do that now. And then there's two bolts that hold the mower on. One is also one of these cone-shaped tapered bolts. And the other one's just a regular bolt. And there's also a spacer that has to be put in. Got the bolts out, and the first one I'm going to put in is the cone-shaped bolt with the spacer. I'm just going to thread that in loosely. And then the bracket for the mower actually has a notch, and so that will sit on that bolt. And then the bracket itself has a spacer built in over here for the top one already. And so I don't need a spacer on that side. And now I'll go ahead and tighten everything up, but I have to tighten it up from this side. So with the rear mounted and secure, I can go ahead and tighten these bolts on the front. Now after you start mowing, you're going to want to check these periodically because they can loosen up. We'll get them good and tight, but if they loosen up while you're mowing, it's going to cause all sorts of vibrations. So you just want to check these regularly. So now that we have the power shaft all installed on the tractor, we're gonna get ready to mount the sickle bar mower. But before we attach it, I wanna go ahead and put on the knife. So now I'm gonna go ahead and insert our knife. One thing you wanna look at when you're using a knife, you wanna make sure that the bar is straight in both directions, so there's no bends or anything in it from the mower getting jammed. So I'm going to slide it in from this end. So now I just want to check my hold downs, and they should just barely be any play in any of these. And these are adjustable hold downs that I got from Webb's Sickle Service. And I am very happy with them. I love being able to adjust them if needed. The other thing I want to check is make sure all my guards are tight. These can loosen up too, and so you want to also periodically check these. So before I start maneuvering this around, because with the knife in there, anytime you move the knife, you could cut something. So I have a guard. And all it is a 4-inch piece of perforated drain pipe that's been cut down one edge. And that just slides right over the rock guards and snaps on. That'll keep me from losing a finger. So getting ready to attach the mower, it's kind of a tricky thing because you're trying to manage two things. You have your pitman arm sticking out here, which you have to get above here so you can attach it to the end of your knife. We're also trying to maneuver this bar into place, and that attaches with a pin right here. Hairpin clip through there. I
Then we can go ahead and attach our pitman. And actually, before I do that, I like to put a little grease on there. So now that's locked on. Next, we attach our chain to our touch control bracket. I don't know what it's actually called, but kind of looks like a boomerang, so that's what I call it. So next thing I have to attach is the drag link, and what that is it's a rod that runs diagonally from the mower up to the tractor. And that's because as we mow, it exerts force backwards on the tractor or on the mower. And so we add this to counteract that. And we actually set the mower a little bit forward. That's called a lead. So when it does encounter those forces, it gets pushed back more to where it's straight, because ultimately when you're operating, you want the pitman to be at exactly a 90 degree angle to your power shaft. So I'll go ahead and I'll hook this up. So now that we have the link hooked in here and the upper end into the square tube, we'll go ahead and tighten down our, I guess you'd call it a set screw. There's a set screw, and then there's also a jam nut as well. This is another thing you want to check for tightness regularly while mowing. So next I have this little bracket here, and that mounts on the torque tube as well. And what this does is gives us a place to hook the chain when the mower is in the up position to carry the load if you're just moving between fields or doing something else with your tractor where you just want to transport it. So this just bolts on. So now I'm going to go ahead and mount the grass board on the end of the mower. This is not the original grass board. This is an all-steel grass board from Koch. It's called a clean sweep, and I like it. It actually does really well, so I'll go ahead and bolt that on. It's made for different styles of mowers, so that's why it's got different holes. But for international, use the inboard hole. The spring gives it a little flexibility. And then the only other thing I want to talk about real quick is the wheel that we have on our mower here. We put this mower on, or this wheel on the mower, so we could mow higher. The type of grass we have, smooth brome, has higher cutting points. And so this is just a wheel we got at the hardware store with a bearing in it that you'd use for like a lawnmower. And then this upright piece attaches where the shoe normally attaches. And this is just a piece of angle iron I cut and kind of rounded off. And then this is just a rod that I cut and bent to fit up in there. And that's it. It holds the mower up about 6 inches. We'll raise the other end up and hold it up with a chain as well, and allow us to cut higher. So now that everything's hooked up and assembled correctly, we hope. I just like to do a test by hand just to make sure nothing's binding. The next step is the farmer's best friend, the grease gun. We gotta make sure we grease everything up and we continue to grease it regularly while we're using it to make sure it operates for a long time. With everything all mounted and secure, go ahead and close this up. When you do, you want to make sure that your pitman is on your tractor is either at 12 or 6 o'clock so you don't break your pitman arm. And then we just put the stay rod on to hold it up. Then we'll be good to go. Once I start the tractor, I'll use this shackle here, I'll hang it in there, and that'll hold it up off the ground. Well, everything's hooked up and we did a short test run. Everything seems to be functioning properly. We'll hopefully be ready to hay here in about a month. What we'll do before we do that is we'll go back over everything, make sure all the bolts are tight and everything is not binding, and we'll just check it regularly, but should be good to go.